Today we're on the trail of Big Louie. His path leads through the hardwoods of Illinois. But Sydney isn't the most patient one in our tribe, so these turkeys better beware.
It's about day four. I've been out in this field, I've been in a tree stand the past 3 days, but today we decided to cut him off. This big buck's in here, about two shooters. Got a young one at the very end of the field who just came out. So we're hoping that Big Louie's behind him. I think it's gonna walk right in this crevice. Right here.
She's already shifted gears, for a doe is heading her way. With a big doe down to start the hunt, I too was off the next day, trying to do the same. Only I'm filming myself while still hunting the open timber. It's a tedious chore, but a big doe is headed my way now. If I can get the camera locked onto her, I'll let her fly.
Well, I just got in the timber. Just cracking light. Hunting on the ground, sneaking around here by myself with a tripod and a camera, my trusty Oneida. After I grunted to her a couple times, she made the fatal mistake of believing I was a buck, and I have slocked her.
I'm Tim Wells, the Slock Master. And I use Morel targets, Carbon Express arrows. I buy from Bass Pro and use cold steel knives. I kill animals with Grim Reapers. Advanced taxidermy brings them to life. I use Muzzy for big fish and wear mossy oak camo. My Oneida bow goes with me in an SKB case. I shoot Umarex air guns and fish from tracker boats. Fox Pro is my go-to call, and I drive a Ford truck, because Ford trucks are tough. Closed captioning is brought to you by Nocturnal. Easy on, easy off. And they work every time.
I smoked her.
We're definitely going to go ahead and clean her. Abby was my cameraman tonight. She said, hey, you killed a doe. I got dibs on the meat. So we're going to clean her and process her. And Abby's going home full of venison. I got to get my tag on this big girl and take her home, load her in the truck. Here we go.
Now that Sid has filled our freezers, it was time to settle in on Big Louie. And it's a cold November morning. From the looks of it, the bucks are really feeling it.
Bucks are coming in and out, trying to ambush Louie.
Sid's got plenty of action in front of her. Just not the one she's after. My family and friends and I are hunting whitetails in the Illinois timber, and we're sure glad you could join us. You can reach out to Clint Sidney or I on Instagram, or go to slockmaster.com. There you can find us on Instagram, Facebook, or watch all our YouTube videos. We even got some cool merchandise, especially if you'd like a spear or blowgun. Meanwhile, we'll look for you in the timber. The deer are rutting, so Sid tries to stay focused. There's a young warrior below. He's posturing. Sid has just rattled and he's looking for a fight. She hopes he will pass without spotting her high above. But old Bushytail has blew the alarm. Every time a deer comes by, he opens his big mouth.
This squirrel has been barking at me literally all morning. So, it's time to show him who's boss.
Yep, show him who's boss, Sydney. Sydney's a killer. She never misses. And just look at him, all stretched out, chilling, waiting for another deer to scare off. That's odd, she missed. Oh, but wait. Sid's going for another shot. Make it count, Sid, because arrows ain't cheap. Whoa. There's a deer to her left, but Sid don't care. She's going for old Sass Lips. Give him some payback, Sid. Wow, Sid, you sure showed him who's boss. Uh-oh, and he's back. Trouble is, Bo don't know squirrel hunting.
Bo's not quite on board yet with the Slock Master's plan, which is slock everything that comes through the woods. We had squirrel for dinner, man, if you'd have shot him. There he goes. We had
what Ducks last night for dinner. Tonight we're having steak and lobster, some
ribeye steaks.
Yeah. At least we got something to look forward to. It turned hot and windy, but we're still after them.
So Bo and I had to cut our hunt short. Seems Clint needed a little bit of help. That's Clint's shadow right there. Yep, he can't hold still. He's too busy watching the traffic passing up and down the road. As he was watching the traffic go by, luckily, he looked to his right and noticed that Big Louie was heading his way. He's self-filming, so he's got to get the camera in place, then grab his Oneida bow for the shot.
He was a clean pass through, and he was dead within. He was dead within the hour.
What do you got?
He's all gray faced. Look at him. He's all beat up. Back of his ears are torn up.
That's pretty awesome. There.
He was rotten. He was foaming out the mouth when he was coming in.
Look at how his rack comes in like that.
Well, he texted me. Dad texted me. He's like, "Seen any luck yet?" And I said, "One just stepped out." And sure enough, he wandered to the cornfield. About 5 minutes later, he's booking it right towards me. I set up for him on the left side where he came to the right, and I had no time. I had to get ready and shoot, and I got him in the window where I wanted them and couldn't stop him, but I let the arrow fly, and it worked out. So
that's awesome.
Good opportunity, good.
This is where Bo wanted to hunt the first night we got here, but I told him Clint was hunting there, so sorry about that, Bo. Clint kind of buck blocked you, but
good he shot my deer.
Yeah. Hey, this is the bow buck.
He shot my deer.
This will go down in history as the bow buck.
I'm never coming back. He shot my deer.
Right.
This is the bow buck.
He shot my deer.
This will go down in history as the bow buck.
I'm never coming back. He shot my deer.
Well, let's get.
With Clint's success, Sydney couldn't wait to get back in her tree stand. She's after a big buck she's named Six Pack. He lives nearby. We haven't seen him yet, but with the help of covert cameras, he's very photogenic. So far, it's a young 2-year-old that's hanging around Sydney's stand. He's pretty. Definitely has some good genetics. He'll be Big Louie one day. The rut has really got him on the move. And here comes another young fella.
Don't move.
It was at this point when our lighthearted mood suddenly took a new intensity. For it was him, and he's coming our way. Sid wants to draw her bow, but the doe is now directly below our stand and looking straight up at us. He knew we were there. He must. For in his last gesture, he looked at Sydney, gave her a nod, and went on about his way.
I'm very defeated. I've been hunting this big buck for about 40 some days now. Finally came in 5 yards, turned his head, his broadside, pulled back on him, and whew, he's gone. He had just no idea we were up there though, so the anticipation and the excitement of seeing the giant Illinois whitetail buck come up on ya. Didn't happen, but it's okay, you know. Just grateful to see a big buck come under me that close. Hopefully he gives me another shot. I mean, he has no idea we were there, so it gets me all excited. But I do feel defeated right now, but got another night ahead of us, so here we go. Many say he is the king of the hardwoods. A ghost. Throughout the timber, we lay in wait, hoping he'll come our way. We use every trick to draw him near. But unfortunately, it rarely works. Life has taught him to be cautious. So he is wise. So who is Big Louie?